So we've looked at one layer type, which is our content layer, which uses movies and images to put content on stage. So let's look at our other type, which is an effect layer. I'm gonna go ahead and clear and sneak these out. And I need to put my server layer back on at full. So we'll do that. And then 514 at full is my first effect layer. And the first thing we wanna do is go look at the library, because we're gonna notice some things that are a bit different. You'll notice that it's a much smaller pool of content, and that's because these aren't actually video files. These are algorithmically based effects. Items that you see in this library that have rainbows on them will generate rainbow content. So let's take a look at an example of that. Let's grab file 5, and that's gonna put a rainbow up on stage. I also have width and height of this content, so I can make my width 13 to make sure that it fills up the whole space. And I can make my height 9. So one of the things that you'll notice is the gradient actually has a slow rolling movement to it. So I can find my playback speed. And if I put my playback speed to 0, then that'll freeze that content. If I increase my playback speed to something like 50, then I get a lot more movement. There's two other parameters that are unique to an effect layer, and those are your layer effects. Your layer effect parameter will determine how many times the algorithm is going to repeat in the space. So if I put layer effect at 50, you can see that my rainbow gets a lot tighter. If I do a layer effect of negative 50, it will spread that rainbow out larger than the space so that I get a much smoother gradient. Let's look at another type of content, Perlin noise. So if I come over to Perlin noise and do a rainbow, I'll get a lot of mathematically generated noise. Here, a layer effect of 50 increases the noise and the pixelation. If I do a layer effect of negative 50, I get much larger noise. Now if I look at layer effect 2, I can put a little bit of animation to this. A layer effect 2 of 50 is going to scroll the content. If I do layer effect 2, negative 50, I get the content scrolling the other way. And a layer effect at 0 keeps the content from scrolling. So let's look at some user-defined colors. Back in my library, anything that's not rainbow or has blue and red colors to it are user-defined colors. So I can do the same Perlin noise, only I have to define the endpoint and the outpoint of the color. And for that, I'm gonna come back to my color picker for start color and end color. So maybe I'll make my start color green, my end color blue, and now I get the same effect, but with colors that I choose. One of the things that's great about effect layers is that it's quick to generate organic content. If you're looking to build a fire look, for example, it may take you tons of research to find the perfect video file that has the fire that you want. But with effects layers, you can create something with a lot of movement and tweak it to be just the way you want. So let's do an example. First thing I'm gonna do is sneak off all this content, clear sneak 0. And again, 5.11 and 5.14 at full. And I'll select just 5.14. So the first thing I'm gonna do is affect my content. And I just want the first Perlin noise that's defined. And I wanna make my start color yellow. So we'll poke that up here. And then the next color that I wanna make from end color is gonna be red, so we get a bit of fire going. Next, I want to give it a little bit more movement. So I'm going to find my playback speed, and I'm going to make that 50%. There we go. But I also want my fire to scroll to look like it has a bit of movement. So I'm going to go ahead and take my layer effect 2 and put that at 50 as well. But now it's scrolling left to right, which most fire doesn't do. So I want to use my rotation tools, Z rotate in this case, to to make my fire scroll up. Remember that your intensities are opacity as well. So on my intensity, I'm going to take intensity 3 and roll it down to about 40 to give it a bit more depth. And now I have a simple fire effect going.